Originally called Placidus, St. Eustatius was a distinguished officer in the Roman army under Trajan. While out on a hunt one day, he perceived the image of the crucified Savior in between the antlers of a stag. He told his wife Tetiana, who relayed that she too had a similar apparition. The pair told the Pope at the time, who then proceeded to instruct them in the faith and later baptized them along with their children. This profound conversion brought about many trials for Eustatius. Persecution broke out against Christians, and our saint lost his commission, all his possessions, and was separated from his family. Reduced to abject poverty, he took work laboring for a rich landowner. When all seemed darkest, circumstances raised Eustatius again to prominence. Attacked on all sides by barbarians, Trajan called upon Eustatius to command his troops. Leaving the plow for the sword, he led a valiant march against the empire's enemies. Favored by the Lord's grace, he miraculously recovered his wife and children while on campaign and returned home victorious. Defeating the barbarian hordes, thanksgiving was in order, and Trajan ordered the hero Eustatius to offer sacrifice to false gods. His refusal meant martyrdom. He, along with his family, were thrown before lions, but the beasts let them unharmed, so the emperor had recourse to entombing them within a brazen bowl and roasting them alive. They gave up their spirits in this way while singing divine praises in 118. In Chartres Cathedral, one can find a rendering of St. Eustatius, along with a stag and bow. He is the patron of hunters and is invoked against family troubles. St. Eustatius, pray for us. Christ our King, thy kingdom come.